To calculate area, we need to find how many squares we have. To make a square, we need two lines at 90 degrees. So when I have two lines at 90 degrees, I'm able to calculate the work out the number of squares I can make squares, which then allows me to count or calculate area. So if I have lines at non-90 degrees, like for example this line here and this line here, multiplying these together gives me no information, because it doesn't make, they don't make squares. These two lines is not going to frame a square shape. So I can only use 90 degree lines. So for example, this line and this line here, okay, that will be able to make squares in here. Okay, I can draw squares in there using those two lines. So I'm going to use those two lines to calculate the area in here. So this line times that line is going to give me 48 meters squared. So that portion there is 48 meters squared. I'm left with a triangle then. Well, I know the length of this triangle is going to be, well, if that's 8, the 8 plus 4 gives me the 12 meters here. And I know the length here is shared at 6 meters, and it makes a 90 degree. So if I multiply those two together, I get 24 squares inside that rectangle. But I don't want the whole rectangle, I only want half of it. So the formula for a triangle is base times height, and they have to be 90 degrees, and we take half of it, so we divide it by 2. So 24 divided by 2 gives me my 12 squares in that triangle. So the triangle then, area, the area of that triangle, or sort of that, this is actually a trapezoid, works out to be 60 meters squared. What's really important calculating area is just making sure you're using 90 degree lengths, lines that are 90 degrees to each other, and also keeping organized in how you keep track of your area parts. And essentially, we want to just break it up into rectangles and triangles, and we can just add up all those parts. As for the perimeter here, we can just add up all the lengths. So for the perimeter, I'm going to add up 8 plus 6 plus 12. That gives me all the way around to here, and I'm just left with this part here. So 8 plus 6 plus 12 is going to give me 26 so far. Okay, so I'm going to call that x. And so plus x is equal to my perimeter. So I just have to figure out x. X is a diagonal line, so we need to use Pythagoras to find out x. And it's the longest side, so we can say that x squared is equal to the two shorter sides squared. So 6 squared is 36, 4 squared is 16. So we know that x squared is 36 plus 16. So the square from the hypotenuse is going to be 52 squares. To find out the length, to go from area to length, we square root. Okay, so I'm going to square root 52. So square root 52 gives me a length of approximately, so I'm going to say this is square root 52, and x is approximately 7.211. I'm just going to round that to 21. So I'm going to replace the x with 7.21. Again, make sure you're keeping track and organized. When I add that all together, I'm going to end up with 33.21 meters. Again, area is squares, length is meters. To find surface area and volume, we need to make a net. So to make my net, need to make sure I know the number of surfaces. There are six surfaces on this net. So I'm going to make sure I draw all six surfaces. Okay, the four surfaces around the outside here, and the two end surfaces I'm just going to place here like this. And then I can just work out each individual surface. So this is going to be 4 by 10, so 40. This is 5 by 10 or 50. This is 50, 40, and the end pieces are going to be 4 by 5, so those are 20 and 20. When I keep it organized, I'm going to be able to keep track of my surface area much easier. So I add that all up, 50 plus 40 plus 50 plus 40, so that's 180 plus 20 and 20 gives me 220 meters squared, because it's, remember, surface areas give me units squared. As for volume is going to give, I need to make cubes. I need three lines that are mutually perpendicular or at 90 degrees to each other. Well, these three lines, 5, 4, and 10, are 90 degrees to each other, so the volume is going to be 5 times 10 times 4, and that's going to give me the number of cubes that make up this volume. I'm getting 200 meters cubed.